Hi, I'm Alan Udy from the Historical Aviation Film Unit, and I'm here at FLAIR NZ at Te Kōwhai Airfield near Hamilton in New Zealand, talking to Peter Maloney from Composite Aircraft Manufacturing Limited about their new kit helicopter. Tell me about your aircraft, Peter.
Okay, we're a New Zealand CA approved manufacturing company, and we've designed what is really the world's first all carbon composite helicopter fuselage manufacturing process. And we believe it's going to revolutionise the helicopter manufacturing industry around the world going forward.
So what's the big benefit? Is it speed of manufacture, or is it the weight of the final aircraft?
There's numerous benefits to be had. The first and foremost is that the manufacturing process is very, very quick, and it's a low-cost manufacturing process. The next advantage that we have is that the airframe itself is very light. And as an example, the black helicopter here, which we launched at Oshkosh this year, weighs in at 370 kilos. And then from there, we add the drivetrain, running gear, and the engine. So the philosophy that we've approached this design with is that apart from a very quick and efficient and a revolutionary manufacturing process and light airframe, is that we are able to over-engineer the running gear, mechanical components, to include a high degree of redundancy, safety, and stability into the rudder system. And the aircraft is designed, it's structurally engineered for 160 knot VNE, 3,200 pound gross weight, and up to 450 shaft horsepower. Design cruise speed using 260 shaft horsepower as max continuous is 135 knots. Basic endurance on the normal standard tanks is approximately 3.6 hours, and the helicopter has been designed to have an auxiliary fuel system which will extend it out to approximately 6.2 hours.
So what do you see the main uses? Is it a workhorse or a transport aircraft?
No, initially this is the first time a helicopter like this has ever been offered as a kit helicopter. And that's quite shocking to some people, because it's a 5/6 seat single engine turbine helicopter. But the actual number of parts that go together to build this aircraft are fairly few. They are large parts, and they're all preformed, and the aircraft is assembled in a specific order, and its manufacturing process is relatively straightforward. And how complex the aircraft goes thereafter really depends on the finishing time and the depth that the owner wants to go to for an avionic installation, interior layout, and paint schemes.
So you mentioned you were at Oshkosh this year. What sort of interest did you get while you were there?
The results from Oshkosh were absolutely phenomenal. We went in there as a novice, the first time as a new helicopter manufacturer, and the response that we got from Oshkosh itself was absolutely phenomenal. And since then, the articles that have been written, reporters that have come through, and professional pilots have had the opportunity to study the aircraft and sit in it, the results have been inspiring. It's very, very encouraging going forward. One of the biggest things that we've found is that this is New Zealand, right? We're New Zealanders, and it's a New Zealand designed helicopter, and everything is manufactured here in New Zealand except for the engine and a couple of selected flight control parts which are manufactured under the FAA system. But by showing the helicopter here in New Zealand for the first time, we've exposed ourselves to some of the world's most experienced helicopter operators and pilots, and the response again has been really good. Yeah, very encouraging.
So whereabouts are you in the manufacturing timeline, as it were? I mean, prototype or?
Currently, the black helicopter here is serial number 2, and it's configured in a 5-seat configuration, like effectively a VIP configuration. And the white one behind is serial number 1, and that is the prototype. That is configured as a 6-seat. Currently, we're doing all our ground runs and our balance checks and checking out drive shaft harmonics. We're waiting on CAA for final inspection, and then we can continue with our flight test program.